Hey everybody, how you guys doing today? SG Reality Live with y'all once here again. And today's video segment's all gonna be about my new Pioneer touchscreen interface radio that's been installed by my dad at his work one night. So huge thanks and special shout out to him for doing that. And yeah, it's a Pioneer AVHX2800BS. And I'll post that in the title and stuff so you guys can see it. And also too, I wanted to be different, so haven't installed in the Chevy Impala itself, because stock radios for the Chevy Impalas, they didn't even have any touchscreen radios for that, or like just made off the factory until like 2014 and newer. So I figured, you know what, let me just be one of those people and do that. And definitely not alone, because I've saw some other people like on Facebook who've done it, and just perfect idea, couldn't pass it up. So hope you guys enjoy this video and let's dive right in. All right, so as you guys can see, it looks very nice, absolutely beautiful. And first of all, just to go for a little quick discussion, we got a dash kit and stuff for this, so it fits perfectly, because you're definitely going to need one. Also too, you need some kind of pack converter like thing, or a nav converter thing. And you may think, oh, nav, like navigation. No, what it means is pretty much, if you were to just like set this radio up and not even like put any kind of converters or whatnot, the volume will not work on the radio, the lights and blinkers and whatnot will go haywire. It kind of just messes with the computer system and just doesn't do good at all. You know what I'm saying? And this applies to 2003, I think, approximately, and newer models. So that's why you need some kind of converter to get a touchscreen radio installed, or any kind of stereo, I think. But anyways, let's just start this up and get right to it. So this is a 6.2-inch touchscreen. You could get the 7-inch touchscreen, but it's a little more, you know, expensive. But still, this is awesome. And yeah, let's get right to it. So first of all, my iPod's already Bluetooth through the system. In case you guys want to know how to do that, all you got to do is go down to that Bluetooth emblem, connection, or you could do it on your phone. And you get to see both my devices, my phone and my iPod Touch, is paired up. And let's get right to it. First of all, we're going to show you guys, before we get to my good stuff, the radio and stuff, it's just extra little functions here. So if you want to go to the main home screen, what you got to do is you got to press that little square button, and here you go. Also too, Pandora Radio, Spotify, those are all ready. You just have to have them installed in your phone, and it just plays right off the screen. So pretty cool, nice. This is the radio emblem, so of course that gets you AM, XM, I mean FM, not XM, doesn't have satellite radio. But anyways, setting screen, let's go up to the star, the favorites. I guess you could save certain stations or something. You get all different like beep tone, camera settings. This could optionally have a backup camera installed. There's actually a port right behind this, but I didn't have that and didn't need the use for that, just extra money. So pretty cool system settings. Then this is where it gets really fun here. You get different kinds of backgrounds and stuff like that. Pretty cool. Then you could change the theme or the color of the background. Illumination is a side part panel, so you could change that to matching or orange or whatever you want to. But really cool. I'm gonna go with the Spider-Man contrast like thing. Also too, clock, you could organize, or not organize, but customize the different format look. So that's pretty damn cool, to be honest. So that's your back button if you want to hit that instead. Audio, get your equalizer and stuff. And I don't know why I can't do anything to this for some reason. Maybe because I'm not playing anything. And video setup, this is DVD compatible, so you guys could pretty much play any movie besides Blu-ray movies on the system. So if you're on a car trip or something, and or just cruising around with your friends, you could watch movies. Obviously don't watch when you're driving, or bad things happen. Let's see here. Phone. My current phone's not whatchamacallit hooked up to it, except for my iPod, which doesn't do any justice. But you could pretty much access your dial pad, your contacts, recent calls, and then voice commands too. That's pretty cool. So very simple and easy to use. So let's play some couple songs here. Let's see. Why does it say dock connector here? That makes no sense. All right. Let's see. May have to go back to the Bluetooth thing to kind of get this all straightened out here. All right. I figured out the problem. I just needed to simply connect to the stereo. So I just got to wait for this to connect here, and then there you go. Well, yeah, you guys could pretty much see here, get the dial pad and stuff. You could choose whether you want to hear it through the system privately or not. Recent calls, address book, voice commands.
Siri not available.
And that's because...
you are not connected to the internet.
Yep, because I'm using my iPod, so of course... Holy crap, man. Shit, was not expecting that. So, alright. We're going to just get right to the music here. Everybody put your hands up. Let's party. Everybody bounce with me. Some champagne and burn a little green. This disco inferno. Let's go. You're now rocking with a pro. I get told to flip go to get show. Get my drink up, nigga. On a dance floor. Seven two step with a little twist. Listen, I ain't gonna listen true to this. Pay attention, boy. I teach you how to do this. You miss a little bit. Carry on in a little Hennessy, you know we finna carry on. Wildin' at the streets in the club, tryna get right. We gon' be a break, bitch, it's gonna be a great day, right? Sounds really good. I love it. Shake that ass, girl. Little mama, show me how you move it. Put your back into it. Alright, just to pause that. Sorry to scare the crap out of you guys. Let's see, if you wanna, like, hit like the functionality button that gets you to like the shuffle or the replay again and whatnot, a Bluetooth. And this is really nice too. You could even change the songs right on the system itself. So you just go to music, my music, or even your custom playlists, and it's really cool. And just take a look. You could literally just like, that's awesome. I love it. I personally love it. So let's just try to find you guys a good song here to play. My favorite song, or one of my favorite songs. Pretty cool.
I was doing just fine before I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue, but okay. Hey, tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them.
Alright, so I think I went over this. I don't know if I didn't or did or not, but this comes with the stereo codes for the microphone. So very nice, and apparently it works really good. So definitely happy about that. So I could make safer phone calls when I'm driving if I really needed to. And yeah, so. So go to the radio functionality. This definitely, this system compared to my stock interface or stereo face, sounds way better, like knocks it right out of the ballpark. Like I could crank it more louder and even listen to the radio for the first time cranking it up loud, where it actually is like way more louder than it was before. So let's get you guys a good channel here, and you get like 18 different presets, so that's nice. About you. So if you guys want to mute the radio, all you got to do is simply press the volume button on the side, and then you could access that functionality. That's the only way you guys could access it. So just to let you all know. Trying to think, what else did I say? I think I went through everything. Actually, it is actually Sirius XM radio ready. I don't know how to do that, but that's pretty awesome just to know. Turning your display on and off too, very simple and easy. And you could just click there to see more details on the radio. And I'm trying to think as to what else. Give you guys one more song and then we'll wrap this video right up. So, and then the mode button, I don't know if I explained this or not, but if you want to go right back to, like, okay, so if you're playing like music on your iPod or something, you want to go back to the radio, I guess if you just hit this, it brings you right back there. So that's cool. If you hit that music emblem symbol, it actually gives you a picture too. Like, that is pretty cool, you know. I like that. Gives you a cool picture of the album cover and that, right? Look at that. Love this. And you can crank it too, it goes to 40.
You know just what to say. Things that scare me, I should just walk away. But I can't move my feet. The more that I know you, the more I want to.
So it's definitely got a unique song list without a doubt. And hopefully it'll pop up. Oh. Alright, here we go. It's a bass song. Try to see.
I got one more problem with you, girl. Hey.
Gotten so intense with the system, my mirrors literally went all the way down just like that. Not even kidding. But yeah, I'm absolutely in love. Thanks again to my dad for hooking this up for me and everything like that. And just I'm just impressed. And I actually have a pair of Pioneer speakers at home too. I think they're like 80 bucks a pair or something like that. And I'm gonna probably even put a video on here as to how to hook those up. So stay tuned, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. There's a lot more that came from. Please like, subscribe to my videos. Pass on the message to your family and friends. And keep it real, guys. Peace out. So